Hi everyone, Zach Reinhardt here for cgboost.com, and in this video let's have a quick look on how I created this transition effect here, which I used for the trailer of my recently updated Blender sculpting course. First of all, let's have a look at how this works in general, because the core principle is super simple. Here I have my sculpting, here I have an empty object, and when I move this empty object, you can see how the transition is changing. So all I needed to do in the end was animating this empty object. You of course can also rotate it, and then the transition is changing from one material to the other. Let's quickly enable Simplify because the sculpting is pretty high resolution. And then let's have a quick look at the material. You can see over here, this whole part is one material. This here is the clay shader, which I packed into a node group. If I tap into the node group, this is what it looks inside. And both are connected to a mix shader. And all I did here was creating a black and white gradient mask, which is connected to the empty object, which is driving the mix factor here of this mix shader. That means, let's have a look over here. This is a gradient, and this is how it looks when this is moving. And all it does in the end is showing one shader on the white part of the gradient and the other shader on the black part of the gradient. So if I reconnect this here, this is how it looks in the end. So, and now let's recreate this gradient effect from scratch. What I don't show here, however, is how to create these materials. This and how to create and sculpt this entire creature from scratch I will teach you in my sculpting course, link down below in the video description. So let's quickly analyze this here. So I have this creature which consists out of multiple parts, and some of these parts have different materials, as you can see down here. And over here I have one sphere with the clay shader which I created, and now I want to create a transition from the clay shader over to the colored version of the creature. As mentioned before, we need an empty object. So let's hit Shift A, go to empty, and add this arrows empty. And over here, let's scale it a little bit smaller. Then let's select the empty with Shift the body of the creature and this ball here. And let's hit slash on the numpad so we can only see these three objects. And in general, it doesn't really matter what kind of material you have here or what two materials you wanna mix. So you can also have UV unwrapped objects here with textures and everything. This would work the same. Here I have a mixture of procedural textures and sculpt vertex colors. But anyway, let's select the body here. Let's hit Shift A and search for the texture coordinate node, put it in here, and search for the gradient texture. So this is a very basic stuff we need. Then let's connect the object output to the vector input of the gradient texture. And as object down here, let's search for the empty object. Well, maybe let's rename the empty into color transition or something like this. Now, when you have the node wrangler add-on enabled, which you can do up here in the preferences under add-ons, search for node wrangler and enable this, then you can press Ctrl Shift left click on a node, and then you can see what it does. And now when I move this object here, you can see how the gradient is changing. So the problem right now, the orientation is wrong. Of course, you could rotate the object down here, but this is not what I want to do. So let's search for the mapping node and plug it in here. And with this mapping node, we can change the location, rotation, and scale of our textures. So in this case, as you can see, I want to rotate the y-axis 90 degrees, and I want to make the gradient less big. So that means I want to have a sharper edge here. And for that, let's simply scale up the scale value here a bit. And to have a nicer transition here, let's change the gradient type from linear to easing. Then we have a smoother transition here. So this is already the basic setup you need. Now you can move this around and you have the transition from black to white. However, now let's make the edge of the gradient a bit more interesting. For that, let's select these three nodes here. Maybe let's move them up a bit, Shift D, move them down here. Then let's grab the texture coordinate node, Shift D, place it down here and remove the object. Then you can use whatever procedural texture you like. In my case, I used a Voronoi texture. Place it over here and connect this with the object output, but this time without the object. So this texture won't move along with the empty object. Control Shift left click on here to see what's going on. First of all, let's increase the scale to get these little dots here. Maybe let's go with something very high here, 400. And then you can play around with a feature feature output, which will change the look of it. In my case, I used the Smooth F1. And then again, to change the look of it, you can also play around with the distance metric. In my case, I used the Minkowski method, which gives us these little stars. Then you can also change the intensity here or the sharpness by playing around with this exponent value. And let's try to use something like 1. So now I want to mix this texture with this one here. For this, let's add a color mix RGB node and connect these two here. Control shift left click over here. And now you can see I just can blend this together. However, then I will lose the details here or the gradient. And in order to better mix this together, change the blending mode to multiply. Then change the factor to 1. And then you can see we can only see the black dots in the white gradient and nothing inside the black gradient here. However, the black dots are now everywhere and I only want them on the edge. For that, let's search for the color ramp and place it behind the gradient texture here. Let's change the interpolation to ease for a smoother transition. Then let's move the white handle to the center. Let's create a new handle, move this over here, and change this to black. And with this setup here, we are cutting out the edge of the gradient basically. And now over here with a mapping node, when changing the X value, we can shift this around. And now I just wanna mix this white stripe here together with this gradient up here. And for that, let's Shift D, duplicate the mix RGB node here, connect this output to color 2 and this output to color 1, then hit Control Shift left click over here. And then in this case, I want to see both white colors. So let's switch the blending mode to overlay. Now you can see we see the white color up here and we can see the little dots over here. And now let's shift them around so they are at the right spot. And if you like, you can also lower the scale value to make the transition a bit wider. And let's shift this around. And this is basically all we need. So this is our entire mask. Let's select everything. Press Ctrl J to add the frame. Select the frame, press N. Go to node and then under label, we can call it mask or something like this. Let's increase the label size here to better see what's going on. So, and all there's left to do now is to mix these two materials. So this one here and the clay shader over here. Let's select the ball here with a clay shader. Let's select this node group, Control C to copy this. And then over here, Control V to paste this. Let's place it somewhere here. Then let's add a shader. Mix shader, place it behind here and plug in both shaders. And now this is just a regular blend between these two shaders. And this is why we are plugging in the output from our mask over here into the FEC of the mix shader. And now you can see when I move the empty, we have this transition over here. However, the materials are now placed wrong. I want to have the clay shader down here and the color up here. So let's just swap these two inputs. So, and now you can totally go up here and play around with the Voronoi texture to change how the transition looks like. So this is totally up to you. And if you want to add a simple bump map over here, you can see that my clay shader has a normal input, which is basically the same thing as for the principal shader down here. And for that, we can add a simple bump node here. Also plug in the output from our mask into the height, this one here, and then connect the normal output with the normal input of our clay shader. And if you like, you could even plug this into the normal input of this bump node from the color shader from the creature. And then you get this crazy bump map, which you can lower by changing these values here. And then you have this interesting bump map where the transition is. And if this is too strong for you, you can also disconnect this from the color shader and only leave it in one of the two shaders. I think then it looks a bit better. So, and that's basically it. Now we can animate this object here and it will create this nice little transition. Let's hit slash on the numpad to get back. And now all you need to do is to copy the setup which we just created to the other materials. That means let's select this one here, then make sure to select the entire top part, this node here, this one and this one. Hit Control C, then go to one of the others, for example, the feathers here, and then here Control V. And then all you need to do is to reconnect everything. So this one goes into the second shader input and this one into the surface input. And now, as you can see, it also works on the feathers. And the same thing you also have to do for all the other elements of your object, which has different materials. But this is not what I will do in this video, since you get the point. Yeah, and in this way I created this transition effect. And if you want to learn how I created all the shaders for the creature and the clay shader and everything about sculpting you need to know, check out my updated Blender sculpting course, link down below in the video description. And don't forget to check out the full course trailer up here and let me know down below in the comment section if there's anything else you would like to know about how I created this trailer. I will see you next time. Goodbye.